Tory MP John Whittingdale has backed Jacob Rees-Mogg's attack on the Brexit Select Committee's proposal to extend the transition period. Speaking on Sky News this morning, Mr Whittingdale said the proposal from the committee, chaired by pro-Remain MP Hilary Benn, was a serious negotiation blunder. The Brexiteer MP was one of the 8 Eurosceptic politicians who backed a minority report that rejected Mr Benn's recommendations. Getty, Sky Whittingdale said the proposal from the committee, chaired by Hilary Benn, was a negotiation blunder. He told Sky News, the problem is that this is a very divisive issue and on the committee there is a majority who voted Remain in the EU and, while they say they accept the referendum result, I suspect they regret the result and if they can stay on in the EU and drag it out, that's what they will do. The report's conclusion were not ones we could possibly sign up to, when they recommend that we should delay further the exit and set an indefinite transition. People are already impatient and in my view, the last thing you do in a negotiation is to say, we may not get an agreement so let's talk even longer. The history of the EU shows that agreements are made at the last minute, when the pressure is really on. What this report recommends is to take the pressure off. Mr. Whittingdale also reminded Mr. Benn and his pro-Remain colleagues that Britain is leaving the EU next year with or without an agreement with Brussels. GETTY MP John Whittingdale has backed Jacob Rees-Mogg's attack on the proposal. The history of the EU shows that agreements are made at the last minute, when the pressure is really on. John Whittingdale, he explained, it's going to happen, it's not dependent on the EU, the fact that there is a set date on leaving will help concentrate the mind. That is the best way to ensure we get an agreement in time. If we say we'll put that date off, it's far less likely that the EU will give us the deal we want. In response to the Brexiteer backlash, Mr. Benn has stated that he is not seeking to overturn a bloc referendum result. The arch Remainer explained, if substantial parts of the new partnership has not been agreed, then the government should seek an extension. If that doesn't happen, the balance of the negotiations alters. What this is about is making sure the length of time is flexible enough so that we get the best deal for the UK whilst we still have the maximum negotiating clout. That's what our recommendation is about.